Welcome. This is the first lecture in a series of five about materials, properties and manufacturing methods. In these lectures, I will briefly discuss the manufacturing of aircraft components and structures. Therefore, materials have to be processed in multiple steps to achieve a structure. It all starts with materials. Everyone more or less understands what a material is, but it is hard to give a clear definition. One definition I often use is materials is a substance or mixture of substances and is used to make parts or components. Key is that a material has specific properties but not a specific shape. If you mention wood, aluminum or iron, we think about a certain substance, not about a particular shape. On the slide you see pebbles having certain shapes, although not specific. The molten metal in the lower picture definitely doesn't have a shape, as it flows like a liquid. How to transform materials into structures? How to use materials to create artifacts like houses, bridges, trains, cars, aircraft, etc. As said before, it starts with materials. When the materials has the right composition, it can be processed into semi-finished products. These products are easy for handling, transporting, etc., but are definitely not in their final shape. A subsequent process is required to manufacture the semi-finished part into a ready component or element. Finally, when a number of elements are joined together, we obtain a structure. I would like to divide all materials in four main categories. These four categories are metals and their alloys, unreinforced polymers, ceramics, and composites. Each category will be discussed in more detail in a few moments. Realize that each category represents a large amount of different materials. The clustering in categories is based on a few important properties. There is one more thing I would need to mention. Of the four categories, only two comprise of useful materials for structural applications: the metal alloys and the composites. The other two categories are hardly used for structural applications because of insufficient properties. For polymers, the strength and stiffness is not high enough. And for ceramics, they are often too brittle, they lack ductility.